Hello, my name is Caroline, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a lithopane start to finish. Now, your first question is probably, what is a lithopane and why would I want to make one? A lithopane looks like a black and white photo, but it's actually a 3D printed white filament photograph. And when you hold it up to the light, it looks like a black and white photo. But a lithopane is actually a 3D printed photograph. Now it is printed quite thin. The maximum width for my lithopanes are about 3 millimeters. And they do take quite a while to print. And I like to have a little light source behind each of my lithopanes. And that takes me to why I would want to make a lithopane. Number one, they make great gifts. And number two, I've heard about people starting entire businesses where all they do is make lithopanes. People turn in their photographs that mean something to them, and then they print them out and they give them a little light source, and then they sell them for big bucks, and especially during the holiday season. So I thought I would try my hand at making a few lithopanes. Now let's get started. Before we get started, I want to give you an idea of what this looks like. What really is a lithopane? So in the intro, I showed you this lithopane. It just looks like a white piece of plastic, quite honestly, without the light behind it. Now I'm going to show you how the lithopane actually looks versus the original photograph. On my left here, this is the original photograph. I'm wearing a blue tank top, black shorts, and blue shoes, and a black visor. In the middle, what I did was I just found a free online image converter, and I've converted the photo to black and white. So this is what it would look like if I take that photo and I make it black and white. Now, on the far right, I have an actual photo of this lithopane with the backlight in its proper surroundings of how it looks when it looks good. And it's kind of a black and white photo, but it's kind of yellowish too. So it's kind of this old-timey kind of look to it. So I just wanted to explain, before we get started, what a lithopane looks like and what you can expect. Now, that also brings me to choices, selecting a photograph for your lithopane. I specifically chose this photograph because it's got a lot of meaning to me. I was running for Team USA, but the other reason I chose the photo is that it had great contrast. It was a really foggy morning and there is almost a white background. My black shorts and my blue tank top kind of stand out. I really liked this photo because it was good contrast, so that makes it a good photo. So as you're thinking about selecting your lithopane photographs, I suggest you take a look at that. And that's really important because these lithopanes take a really long time to print. This lithopane, the one that you see on my screen here, took over 6 hours to print. You really want to choose your photographs very carefully before you get started. Now, the other thing I want to show you is when I Google search a lithopane picture, a bunch of Etsy listings showed up, and you can buy a lithopane right here on Etsy. Now, obviously, I'm not familiar with anybody. I am not one of these Etsy sellers I'm showing you right here, but just to show you that people do make a living out of creating lithopanes for other people. For this project, what you'll need is, number one, you'll need your 3D printer. Very important. Number two, we use white PLA filament for this. I have heard of people trying other colors. I don't think they come out quite as well. I have not even tried other colors yet. So I am just using plain white PLA filament for this project. There are quite a few brands that work, and you know, really depending on your 3D printer, you might want to pick a certain brand that you like of just regular white filament. You will also need a really good photograph. The other thing you'll need is you'll need a Windows or a Mac computer. I don't believe you can do this if you just have a tablet or on your phone or something. Last but not least, you will need some sort of light source. Now, some people use a flashlight. You could do that. What I've kind of figured out though is I use something called a fairy light. I bought a pack of 12 of these on Amazon. I will link to it below as to what I purchased, and it was about $10 or $11 for a pack of 12. With taxes and everything, it broke down to about $12 for 12, so it's about a buck each. I custom print a holder for each of my litho panes for it to sit on. Now let's actually make a litho pane. I'm going to 3dp.rocks/lithopane. I will link to this in the description field below. And it just starts off with just a plain litho pane here. There's no image. I'm gonna hit images. I'm gonna select my image that I want to use with this. Image I'm going to use this time. I'm gonna drop that right here. Shows right up. Now I like to do something called outer curve. You could do just plain flat, and that's the default. It's really, really, really popular to do outer curve. So I'm gonna hit outer curve, and then I'm gonna hit refresh, and it should stand right up. There it is, outer curve. Now I'm gonna go into the settings, model settings, and really you can set this the way you want to. You can set the size to where you want it to be, and you wanna look at, you know, how big you want this. So maximum size, let's say I'm going to set it back to 70. That's kind of my default. Thickness, 3 millimeters. I do like to have a border around all of my litho panes. That's just personal preference. And also because it's on a stand, so it doesn't go all the way down. So anyway, the border thickness will be 3 millimeters. And now I am going to go into settings again. I'm going to go to image settings. In my opinion, I like positive image better. And what you see in the photograph that I showed you at the beginning, and I could probably pull it back up again, this is positive image. Negative image would be the opposite of it, where everything dark would be light. I think it makes more sense to do positive image, so I've set all of mine to positive image. I don't touch the rest of these settings. All right, so that takes me to the model, and I can refresh the model to make sure everything is the way I like it, and you can kind of take a look at it while it is on the page here. All I have to do is hit download. How easy is that? And you've made your first litho pane, and it comes across as an STL file. What do I do with this STL file? How do I take a look at it? If you are familiar with 3D printing by now, hopefully you are familiar with a slicing software. I use Cura as my slicing software, and it is loading up right now, and we'll just take a look to see what I just made. And I'll take my download, I'll drop it into Cura, and sure enough, here it is. And this is my litho pane. So it doesn't look like very much, quite honestly. The other question you might have is, why is it standing straight up? Whether it's flat, which is a default, or if it's curved, the best practice is to print your litho pane straight up and down. This is a little bit scary if you're not experienced at 3D printing, or if you have a lot of bed adhesion issues. Before you start printing your litho pane, make sure you've got everything, your printer just dialed in. Okay, once again, these are really long prints. And then, so your next question is, what are the settings for Cura, or what are your slicing settings in order to print this thing? I already have a litho profile here to just kind of give you an idea of what my litho settings are. My layer height, I choose 0.12. You can do 0.1 or 0.12. Wall thickness, 1.6. Infill density is 99%. I will show you something to show you why it's set to 99%. PLA I'm using, 205. Build plate temperature, 60. And my print speed I have at 45. Really, they kind of want you to print really, really slow. So if this is your very, very first print, really you want to do maybe 25, 30 as your millimeters per second. You want to print very slowly here. And then, of course, you do want to enable retraction, so your retraction settings should be about the same. Your combing mode should be not in skin or even all. That's up to you. Most important part, you want to print with a brim. Because you are printing straight up and down, in order for it to stay on the bed for 6 hours while it prints vertically, you're going to want a pretty big brim. So I set my brim to 8 millimeters. I will hit slice, and Cura is not really accurate in telling me how long it's going to take for me to print something, quite honestly, but I'm going to go through and slice it. It is a little bit slow on the slicing here, and it says it's going to take 2 hours and 51 minutes to print. Then we can send that over to my printer. I use Octoprint as well. If you're not familiar, I will link to an article below that just details out how to set up Octoprint with your 3D printer. And I do want to point out to you one more thing. Settings. Once again, I have this gadunky.com. There's a whole blog post about those settings that you need. I will link to this post below. And what's really cool about this, he does go through this whole, please set your infill to 99 and not 100%. Brim is vital. I just talked about that. That's super important because you're always printing vertically. And if you don't want to read all that, learn all that, that's okay. Just scroll on down. And if you have a CR10, or if you have a 10 mini, or if you have an Ender 3, he has the Cura profile right here for you to download. And also, if you use Simplify 3D and you have these printers, you can download his profile. I'm going to send that off to the printer. The other part is this holder. So you can just hold up a flashlight, okay, to the back of your lift, okay? If you want a all-in-one solution, as I said at the beginning of this video, I bought this very light. I twisted it around. I make a custom holder for every single one of my litho panes. I haven't figured out a better process because all my litho panes are all just slightly different sizes. I don't use standard size photographs. I'm just using, you know, the photograph that I like that's meaningful to me. And so what I'm going to show you is I'm going to show you how I make a litho holder. And to start off, what I've done is, and I will link to this below, is on Thingiverse, I've uploaded a base model. I've uploaded just, here are the pieces of a litho pane holder. Where the litho pane sits, I'll make a little groove so that my litho pane will sit right into it, like this. This other piece, I'll join it together with the very light. You can download the basic file. It's free on Thingiverse. Then I go over to Tinkercad, and then you can place the two pieces on here, which we will join together. And the other thing I want to do is I want to import that STL I just made. I'm going to hit import, and this will take a minute here. And here it is. Here is the litho pane I just created. Excellent. Yeah, it doesn't look like much. But what I do with it is I take it over, and I'm going to move it up first of all. So I move it to about 1.5 millimeters, so it kind of sits into that thing. So I'm going to hit up, 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 right? And then I am going to resize this so that it fits properly. So then I'll hit shift, and I wanna make it so it's a little bit smaller. And all right, so I'm just gonna play with it so that it fits properly. There we go. Yeah, so this is really up to you how you want to design this. I select both pieces, and I'm going to just make sure they're all centered. Now what I'm going to do is I am going to click on just the litho pane, and I'm going to hit hole. And now you'll see that it's going to make a groove in my litho pane holder. Now what I've found out is that I don't know why this is not how it's actually going to print out with these ridges right here on the side. What I found out is sometimes a litho pane just doesn't get imported perfectly in Tinkercad every single time. Perhaps if I used a different program, maybe it would take all of the points. I think there are just so many points with a litho pane. So what I've done is I figured out that I can duplicate my litho pane, and then I'll take the second litho pane and I'll move it forward one on the y-axis or backwards one, and I'll just make that opening, that ridge, just a little bit bigger, and it helps it fit in. So I'll change my measurements to 0.25 millimeters, and then I will click on one of my two litho panes, and I will move it backwards. That should make the groove for the litho pane to sit on just not too tight. And then you want to group this all together, and I'm going to group this. And now you should see, once this is done, you should see a nice little groove in the holder. And let's check it out. Yep, there is a nice little groove in the holder now. Excellent. I also want to look at the height. I don't want this a little too tall for my item. Ungroup this again so that I can see the height. All right, so I think it's a good height, actually. I'm not going to adjust the height, but you can adjust the height on this thing. You just have to ungroup it, and then you can adjust the height. So let's say my litho pane is 69.73 millimeters tall. You could make you want to make it just a little bit shorter. So maybe I want to make it 63 taller. All right, there we go. So now we're just going to group that together. All right, excellent. So everything should be good now. And I'm just going to just group everything together. All right, there we go. Export this file. I'm going to export it as an STL. I do print everything separately, all right? So what I'm going to do is in Cura, we're going to print this lithograph on its own. It's going to take a while to print, 3 hours or so. Then I'm going to clear the build plate. I'm going to take my new file, my holder file, put that on here. I'm going to change my profile to my standard quality profile that I use just to print regular PLA. And I'm going to slice that and I'm going to print that separately. And yes, of course, you could print it using white PLA. You could print it. I have a lot of other colors just on hand, so I do print it with other colors, but totally up to you. To end this video, I'm going to show you the output and the final assembly process. I printed my litho paint in white PLA, and this is what it looks like. And then I printed the light holder in blue PLA, and I've got this fairy light I purchased a 10 pack of this fairy light. See, there is a battery cover. Pull that out. Let's see if this turns on. Yes, it turns right on. All right, turn that off. And now we'll unwind the fairy light. Here's the fairy light. Now to get this on my holder, hopefully you can see this, I have neatly printed a little hole in the bottom of the holder, and that is where the light is threaded through. So hopefully you can see this. I'm going to thread my light through the hole and pull it out on the other side. Now I'll start winding the lights around this holder. And I do want to make an effort to have all of the lights facing the litho pane itself. And here I am, I'm winding the lights. And here are the lights. Now on the back, you have a little battery holder that is part of the 3D print. And now I can put my litho pane in the ridge here, snap that in, and then we'll turn on the light. And here is my final project. This is my photograph turned into a litho pane. I've got all the lights facing my litho pane and this lovely battery operated switch. And that's how I make a litho pane. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe and I'll see you next time. Bye now.